Cena SSB fight King Kamina Philadelphia Victor SSB. I'm sorry, I didn't know he was Philadelphia. Whatever.
It's okay. From us New Yorker point of view,
is he
he's
Philly
New Jersey
or is
light.
He New Jersey? Because I just
no, he's
heard
definitely
like,
PA.
He's definitely PA. Okay.
Yes.
He's definitely PA.
Absolutely.
And everything outside of New York is basically the same state. Anyhow.
That's a fact.
Okay, this is such a big damage opportunity for Odyssey, thinking he'd be able to get the double up tilt, but was still able to frame trap King Kamina because he option selected that that air dodge.
Yeah, and also, you notice that he went Greninja. Earlier we saw him playing Palu, but he is not doing that. Greninja as a character, his archetype of being this super fast zone breaker means that, you know, the most integral part of, you know, Richter's game plan is to wall people out. It's so hard to do that when, you know, your opponent is as fast and agile as Greninja.
Yep, absolutely. Right now, this is so scary for Odyssey. He has to find a way to get back onto stage without snapping onto ledge, because once he is on ledge and that holy water is active, can you let me finish my sentence before you do the ledge trapping already? I mean,
rude.
Yeah, that's gonna happen. It is so difficult to get back onto stage against Belmont. You have to watch the spacing of the holy water. But that's
that
a jab block. Yes.
Great setup from Odyssey. The drag down up air, able to confirm into a stock. That's exactly what he needed. These earlier percents kind of need to go in his favor. He has a lot of low percent damage, low percent combos that he can get. And he needs to be doing that. Oh, one thing we haven't seen, the offstage game. What?
You love to see it.
Okay.
Okay, so maybe that's a little bit of like lack of familiarity with the matchup. Like, he should have known that like Belmont had no way to get back on stage after that. Well, maybe he just
went
didn't
forward
see
air, right?
Yeah, no, that was the series of the back airs, and then he just got hit with the up B.
No, was it the up B or was it the forward air from Belmont?
It was the up B, wasn't it?
Was it? We might have
yeah,
to get
yeah, because he tried there. To go for another. Oh, that was.
Yeah, I mean, well, that's the thing, is that Uppy is much more reactable. He knew that he was already dead, so he just went for a forwarder to try and save spike him. That was really smart from King Kamina. Like, honestly, don't discredit how genius that forwarder in that situation was.
Also, that was a pretty sick thing that King did to, like, land right. A little bit. Nice back action from Odyssey. Just a good job of, like, sealing out the stock. When you're fighting a Belmont, you have to exploit when they're off stage, absolutely. I like what he did when he footstooled Odyssey's up air. We call that the gimmer.
Isn't the gimmer like seven things by now?
It's one of them. I don't know.
Is it just like a cue where like the most recent thing gimmer's done is now the gimmer?
Yeah. All right. And then after like he discovers like the next, I don't know, so tech, that becomes a new gimmer. This becomes the footstool mash. Regardless, we are going to be seeing the same exact game as we saw before. Odyssey, you know, definitely, if I was him, I would not be a little too happy about how I lost my second stock. Because that felt a little...
Honestly, if I'm King Kamina, I'm not happy about how I lost my last two stocks. Both of those were just from effective edge guards, which is to be expected, but, you know, it can't just be... Like, you're going to lose if every time you wind up off stage, you eat seven back airs and die.
Oh, and Odyssey, like, using the tip of his back air, but unfortunately, King Kamina was able to fall out of it. Really nice catch on the aggressive landing on the shield. I'm not sure if he has enough time to hold shield after he crosses up with Nair. He might. Not sure.
I do also want to just note that this is winner's quarters, so winner of this is guaranteed top 8.
Huh.
Which I don't know if King Kamina has ever made top 8 before. It's been a while since Odyssey made top 8 either, I think.
Well, at Xeno, this might definitely be a first. Odyssey has made top 8 a couple of times every time the team mates. He does super, super well. That is going to be the back throw. Get a little bit of stage control. He tried to catch an anti stage recovery. Maybe an air dodge, perhaps an early up with that dash attack.
That air dodge is so good. The fact it was directional, was Odyssey wasn't prepared for it. I like the idea of that, just getting guaranteed damage, putting Odyssey off stage, but will he be actually to get a stock? Yeah, ever since that first stock in game one, Odyssey's just not getting ledge trapped. He's getting off ledge for free every time, he's jumping away from it.
and that down air actually beating out and perhaps even trading whatever option Odyssey threw out. Back here is going to do a great job of sealing out the stock. Right now, Audi, as long as he holds stage control, like King Kamen is going to find it very, very difficult to actually take the stock. But as I say that, he retreated into the corner and he got hit with holy water, but his SDI was very, very on point.
You know, I find it to be a thing that against the Belmonts, whenever I lose, I'm like, okay, why did I lose? And like a lot of the times it's I got hit by Axe and holy water.
Yep.
Like when that happens, you lose. And Odyssey has been doing a good job of not getting hit by either of those moves.
And that is going to probably be the stock.
Oh!
Whoa.
That wasn't an option select. That was a cold and calculated plain footstool. That was so good.
At that point, there really wasn't anything else that he could have done. He had to hold that.
He
could have upbeat a little bit earlier. He was maybe trying to wait for the Odyssey to throw out an aggressive option so that he could counter it. But Odyssey exploiting the offstage.
Oh! That was... Oh, my... Odyssey was so cool in that last game.
He just dragged on up and off stage.
And keep in mind, Greninja's character where, like, he doesn't spike easily. His one spike, kind of not really the sort of thing you usually go for, you know? You have to do it from very high if you don't want to just die off the bottom.
Catching that jump, such a good lead.
And it's just so smart. The fact that he went for the footstool in order to get that sort of pushing him down, and then he went for the drag down up air. Odyssey looking really good tonight. He's in winner semis, and I could honestly see him going further, especially the way his Greninja's just shaping up right now.
Yeah.